So this desktop here is running Windows 10, and you might be wondering, Henry, why do you have a Windows 10 computer? The answer is because I wanted something to run some basic games. Feel free to look through what I play. This desktop has 16 gigs of RAM, an i7-6700, an SSD, and a GTX 1070, which I think is more than enough to run any operating system, including Windows 11. Microsoft disagrees. Aside from just not being supported, Microsoft has announced that they are cutting security updates beginning in October for all Windows 10 users. I'm gonna break down all the options you have if you also have a computer running Windows 10 and how to get it on Windows 11 that are all legal and very easy to do. Now, right before I get into the options, I want to make something very clear because Microsoft has come forward and has said that we need more secure hardware, and I am all for more secure hardware. But Microsoft has managed to somehow convince the entire internet that there is only two options, that they either have to support all hardware and make everyone insecure, or set stricter hardware requirements and cause perfectly good hardware to go to waste. Notice there's a missing option, which is that they can support older devices on Windows 10 and still push basic security updates, and they can still require more secure hardware for Windows 11. Those things can both be true, and I think that's not asking too much from a nearly $3 trillion company that literally invented a new state of matter. The first option is their extended security updates program. I think out of principle, nobody should do this. Because this is Microsoft saying, yeah, we're cutting support, but we can still do support. If you're an individual, it's gonna cost you $30 for 1 year. We don't know what that's going to cost for year two, or if there even is a year two, but out of principle, I really hope that people don't just go to this. But technically, this is option one. Option two is pretty simple because it's using LTSC, which is essentially their enterprise version of Microsoft. The only problem is, you can't really get this legally, but if you are able to somehow magically install LTSC, you will be able to essentially keep it going, and it is supported for a long length of time beyond just their October 2025. The next option is kind of similar, but it's a way to get Windows 11 LTSC. There was a specific Windows 11 LTSC update that actually reduce these weird hardware requirements that Microsoft has imposed. And so, if you're able to get a copy of that, then you are able to essentially install that on your computer. There are two current methods at the time of making this video to try to bypass this stupid restriction. And it kind of depends on your system, if it's the CPU that's causing issues, if it's the TPM that's causing issues, tons of different things. But let's just try the first one here, which is the official Windows 11 installer can sometimes just work. So I'm gonna give that a shot. Just type in Windows 11 Install Assistant and you'll find a URL. I went ahead and opened it up. You're gonna click yes. Apparently you have to download some other thing because they couldn't bake that into the installer because that would make too much sense. So I can go ahead and apparently check now. And it doesn't because of my CPU. So that is the formal reason. Apparently an i7-6700 is not a good enough CPU to run Windows 11. If I go back here and I click refresh, it says it doesn't meet the requirements and I am not able to do that. Now, an alternative is there is a registry workaround that can sometimes work. First, you open the registry editor by doing regedit.exe inside of just the basic Windows search. It's gonna open here and then you're gonna go into the directory hkey-local-machine. System. Now under setup, you're gonna look for MO setup, but if you don't see that, you're gonna click new, key, and then name it yourself. So you recreate it, MO setup. And once you have that, you go to that key, click new, you're gonna do a D word value, and you're gonna copy the code from the URL in the description. I will leave it down there, but you're just gonna go ahead, rename, paste, enter. Then you double click that and set the value to 1 and click okay. From there, to see if this method will work for you, we're gonna download the Windows 11 ISO. To download the ISO, you just go to their website and instead of doing the installation assistant, you're gonna go down and you're gonna do Windows 11 disk image. And you're just gonna do the Windows 11 and click download now. And I'll get back to you once it's done. So the ISO is done downloading. And the reason why it's good to try this registry method first is that if it works, we'll see if it works for me, but if it works for you, the cool thing is you can just do an upgrade without losing your files and you don't have to start from scratch. So that is the goal. So we're gonna go ahead and try this out. We're gonna open, and you're gonna just do the setup file here, click yes, and we're gonna see if we can get this to work. Install Windows 11, click next. Now, while this is checking for updates, I want to assume that this won't work for you, and I have not confirmed this is going to work for me yet. But let's say that this registry, you know, workaround doesn't work for you. And the reason why it may not work for you is that this will only work because of certain reasons that you can't upgrade to Windows 11. So I just have a CPU that is apparently not good enough for Microsoft standards, even though some new CPUs are less powerful than mine. But let's say for whatever reason, this registry method, which again, I will leave in the description, doesn't work. Well, we are going to do the second method so I can show you what it looks like. The downside to the second method is, again, you will lose all your data. So this does require a clean installation, but I'll show you how to do it nonetheless. What you do is you type in Rufus, R-U-F-U-S. You're gonna open it up. This is gonna create a bootable media for us so that you can install Windows 11 from a flash drive. So to download, you're just gonna get the latest release. Go ahead and save that, open it up. And now we have Rufus. If I pick up my phone, you're actually going to see that I already plugged in my flash drive. Make sure it's a large enough flash drive to hold Windows. To do this, again, you actually still have to download that ISO I already showed you how to download. So make sure you still did that step. Let's go back to Rufus, and you're gonna go ahead and select that ISO that we downloaded. It's gonna take a second for Rufus to scan the image. Once everything's good to go, you're gonna click start, and you're gonna have some options here, and this is where the magic happens. Because with Rufus, they will actually remove the requirement for 4 gigs of RAM, secure boot, and TPM 2.0. They can also remove the requirement for an online Microsoft account, which is super useful. And of course, you can even get a head start and just create a local account with username Henry. You don't have to do that, but it can save you time. If you're starting from scratch and you don't mind starting anew, this is actually the cleanest way to do it. So once you do this, just click OK. And then of course, all data on device will be gone. So just click OK, and it's gonna do its magic. Now, even though I'm a huge proponent of Rufus, and as you can see, it's doing its magic and copying things to that flash drive that I have plugged in, and I'll show you what to do with that in a second, this actually just finished up. So what needs your attention here is that it does warn you that Windows 11 is not officially supported on this system, but because we did that whole workaround with the registry editor, I can go ahead and just click accept. So just to recap again, you have two options. The first one is using the registry edit bypass, which is what's currently working, and you can do this as of today. But then you download the Windows 11 ISO after you do the edit, you go through, you accept that yes, it's unsupported hardware, and now you're gonna see you can choose to keep your personal files. That is the big win over here. Over on the Rufus side of things, all you do is download Rufus, download the same ISO. So either option, you're gonna download an ISO. With Rufus, you select the ISO, and then when you click start, you're gonna have those options. Some of these are personal preference, but the main thing you need to check is the top one. No matter which option you do, make backups. I'm not going to, because this is just like a gaming PC to me. Like, I don't give a crap if I lose all my data, but that's not everybody's computer. So you can go ahead and just keep personal files. I would recommend doing this if this works, just to keep your data. But if you want a fresh start, use Rufus. Now, while these are both taking forever, I actually wanted to quickly touch on the last way to actually get proper security on an old machine that Microsoft doesn't want you to install on Windows 11. And if neither of these options work, I really want to push this last one, which is Linux, L-I-N-U-X. Any Linux distro will probably work on your hardware, will not keep you away from it, and will get you the most modern security updates possible. I cannot recommend Linux enough. If you've never tried it, you can also consider dual booting, so you can run both Windows and Linux on a desktop like this. I just made a Linux tier list that kind of goes through the main Linux options that's on the screen over here. But all you do is, instead of selecting the Windows 11 ISO in Rufus, you just download an ISO for Linux and do that instead. And then you're gonna follow the instructions that I'm gonna show you soon when we boot that flash drive. But yes, you can just use Linux instead and just dodge all the Microsoft stuff, get better privacy, get more freedom, use open source software, and actually own your stuff a little bit better and just dodge all of this. I also understand if you can't do that. I know a lot of people prefer Windows for gaming or for professional work, but it would be really crazy for me to make this video and not at least suggest this as an option, as it's a completely great option for a lot of people. The bar just keeps spinning even when it's at 100%. So while this is stuck at 100%, I wanted to at least explain the debate of whether or not this is intentional by Microsoft and what their intentions are. The first group of people think that this is all about security, all about cybersecurity, and Microsoft is in a position where they're forced to require you to update to new hardware, and it just is what it is. Microsoft just really cares about you. Second camp of people think that this is all intentional to get you to either buy new hardware for Windows 11 or to pay for their frickin' ESU paywalled program, extended security updates, so that you pay for security updates from here on out. Either way, they're getting money. And my problem with both of these options, whoever is right or whatever the reality is that you shouldn't have to pay for basic security on your computer that has perfectly functioning hardware. This is not right, and it's terrible for the e-waste problem that we already have and getting people to buy hardware they don't really need. Okay, and now we have the registry edit method completely done. So it says it install Windows 11 Home, keep personal files, and I'm gonna go ahead and click install. And this is gonna go ahead and install Windows 11, and I will report if it works shortly. And after I went to grab dinner and I'm back, it looks like I am on Windows 11. And then you're gonna go through the regular Windows 11 setup. This is gonna be the same for everybody. Impressively enough, once you are logged in, it actually still saves your Windows before the upgrade. But as you can see, it's running Windows 11. And that concludes the version of editing your Windows registry and just updating and keeping your data and your files. Now, if this doesn't work for whatever reason, let's go ahead and pan over to the flash drive. And I'm gonna show you, we're gonna act like this is still running Windows 10. I didn't succeed, none of this worked. Let's do it. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna power off your machine, and then you're gonna have to boot into your boot menu. This is gonna be different for every device, but what you're generally gonna do is you're going to power it on, and then you have to spam different keys. I'm just gonna try F12, but sometimes it's F2. Boom, boot options. Okay, so everyone's computer is gonna look a little bit different, but this is your boot manager. And what we have is this USB, and as you can see, there is the USB 1. Your thing could be labeled differently, but generally you're looking for some kind of USB. You're gonna hit enter on your keyboard, and this is the Rufus USB that we set up. So I'm gonna use my mouse here, click next, next, install Windows 11, I agree, next. And again, Rufus already did all the work for us in terms of bypassing the compatibility requirements and also even bypassing the online account requirement. You're gonna click accept. You actually can see my two disks here. There is an open HDD, a regular hard drive, and then there's my SSD here. This is normally where I would install this. So this is actually my faster drive. This is already where I installed Windows 11, right? But we're still on Windows 10, just keep going along with me. From here on out, you can look up any tutorial on YouTube for just a generic Windows 11 setup menu, and I'll leave one in the description to help you out if you need any help from here. So first thing is, I like Windows 10, I hate Windows 11, why not just stay on Windows 10? My immediate response is A, you might have programs that simply depend on Windows 11, so this might actually be a requirement for you. Some games require Windows 11, there's a lot of reasons why you might need Windows 11. Second, I highly, highly, highly discourage staying on Windows 10 after you no longer receive security updates. Any new vulnerability, anything out there that can possibly lead to your data being compromised or you installing a virus, getting malware, you're more and more likely to be victim to these threats the longer you go without security updates. The moment I lose security updates on any system is the moment I know that it's pretty much done for me. So I would say either start looking at ways to switch to Linux or just tough out the fact you're gonna need to use Windows 11 at some point. Next question, is this risky? So everything that I showed to you, if you do backups and you back up your data and you have a copy of your data, is actually extremely safe. Even if you fail, let's say you shut down your computer while you're installing Windows 11 and it corrupts everything on your system, as long as you still have a backup of your data, you're going to be fine. Nothing I did today is that unofficial, is overall fairly accessible. It doesn't require downloading anything illegal. You're installing official versions of Microsoft just via methods that Microsoft doesn't really push you to do right away. So these are kind of little secrets, but none of it's illegal. All of it's generally safe, and as long as you follow the instructions and you're keeping up with any updates, so always check the pinned comment and the description for any big updates that I leave down there, you should be fine. But again, always keep backups. Next question, will Microsoft prevent any of these in the future? Or if you actually manage to get Windows 11 on your system, will they prevent you from installing security updates on Windows 11? The answer is, I have no idea. I can't predict the future. I don't know what Microsoft's going to do, but you don't really have much of a choice right now either way. Your options right now are to stay on Windows 10 and no longer get security updates and someday maybe get hacked. You can pay Microsoft a subscription to not get hacked and keep Windows 10. Until they decide not to do that anymore. Or you can buy a brand new computer and throw your current one in the trash. Or if none of those sound good to you, which I don't think any of them do, you can just go ahead and install Windows 11 through the methods I showed you. Or get Linux and bypass this issue altogether. The reality is, you're in a tight spot right now, so you might as well act on it. And the last question I can imagine that I really want to reiterate is, will this remove my data? If you do the registry edit and you kind of just go through the official installer like I showed you, it'll actually not wipe your data. So I showed you exactly what that looked like. All of the games that I originally had there are now in Windows 11. Now, if you went through the Rufus method and you went through a flash drive and you installed Windows from scratch on a flash drive, it will wipe your data. So that is starting from scratch, which has certain benefits, but it might not be for everybody. But either way, you should always assume your data will get wiped and keep backups just in case, because you never know. And that, my friends, is how you get away from this stupid restriction of Microsoft trying to get you to buy a whole new device, which is their officially stated thing that you should do, instead of just following this guide and finding a way to get Windows 11, or you can get away from Microsoft's shenanigans altogether and just move to Linux. These are the methods that Microsoft doesn't want you to know. I want to thank our sponsor, both NotSnook and Redact. NotSnook is an open source end-to-end encrypted notes provider, and Redact allows you to delete all of your data online from different services like Facebook, Reddit, Discord, etc. Links below to both of those. I also leave links to any of the things I talked about today. And if any of this worked for you and there was a method that you preferred, leave it down in a description and let other people know things that helped you on the journey. If you're more curious about Linux, check out this video here on the screen where I talk through some of the Linux options and a general tier list of things to explore if you want to check out Linux, which I think is the best way to try to get around all of Microsoft's shenanigans. See you next time on Techlore. Thanks for watching.